Hello, Dr. Nitin here. In this video, we are going to see Morph feature in greater detail. Now, just to recap what I showed you in the earlier video, what Morph requires is two slides at least where something has changed. So in the first slide, there are two planes. In the second slide, the position of both the planes has changed. Now, when you apply Morph from transition, another thing which you can change is the duration. Otherwise, by default, it is 2 seconds. Now I have made it 8 seconds. What does that mean? Both these planes have 8 seconds to travel from beginning to end. And the in-between animation is going to be managed by PowerPoint. Now notice that the smaller plane has to travel lesser amount of distance, so it will appear to travel slowly. So let's see that in action. Okay, so far so good. So now let's go further and understand the core principle. First slide, a small shape, a duplicate of that slide. The only thing I have changed is the position. Second slide, you go to transition, apply morph, and I have done it to 5 seconds. Now see what happens and notice the animation carefully. There is some acceleration, then it picks up speed, and there is some deceleration, and it stops nicely and slowly to avoid abrupt starting and ending. So now let's see how this could have been done for 20 years in PowerPoint using simple animation. So I have the same box, but this time I have applied motion path animation. It goes from beginning to end, accelerate, decelerates. This kind of animation doesn't require to duplicate the slide. You just click on the object, go to add animation and choose motion path linear, and then decide what final position you want. Nothing new. This appears to be similar, but the traditional animation does give you more control. For example, if you look at the animation pane here and see what it allows me to do, if I double click on it, notice that I have 2 seconds of total duration and 1 second is acceleration, another is deceleration. That means there was no time to stabilize the speed. Now, if I don't want that, and that's what I'm doing in the second one, I have removed the acceleration and deceleration. Exactly the same movement, but look at the way the movement happens now. It'll start abruptly and stop abruptly. It doesn't look nice. That's why by default, smooth start and smooth end is given. But there is a third option, which hardly anybody has explored, but it's really nice visually, is I want this thing to actually bounce at the end. And what does bounce at the end mean? I have whatever 0.5 seconds of total duration to move from beginning to ending. And out of that 0.45 seconds, it is supposed to bounce. That means it has just 0.05 seconds to actually do the movement. Now, what does bounce mean? Best to see. So this is called bounce. And I have just said repeat until end of slide. So it's actually repeating it. How did I do that? I went here to timing and said until end of slide. So this kind of control you don't get on using Morph. But never mind, let's see what Morph can do, which animation can't do easily. So now the same starting point. This time the ending point is different. I have moved the box, rotated it, and changed its shape. And in the third step, again, I have moved it, resized it, and changed the color. So now the second and third have Morph applied. Let's see how this works. Notice, without me doing any animation, it resized it nicely and smoothly and changed the color also in a smooth manner, not abruptly. This is really cool. Now that we have this knowledge, let's try to create Microsoft logo. This logo is just 4 boxes, 4 squares rather. So I have the same logo. I duplicated the slide, put it above the original one, and I have just moved those guys outside and I have changed their shapes also. Second slide, which is the intended final position, has the morph transition applied. And now see how easily I could create a logo. I really wish morph gives me bounce end, but maybe in the next version. Now that I know this, we'll apply this even more nicely. So I start with the same position, but I don't go to the ending position directly. I just let those boxes play around with each other. And then finally they decide, oh, this is the right way. So show some confusion and boxes trying to rearrange themselves. Now the idea is, of course, these 1, 2, 3, 4 slides have morph applied. But the issue is when I show this slide, nothing will be shown. When I click, I don't want to waste time clicking 1, 2, and 3 times. So what I do in addition to apply morph and changing the timing is I also make the slides advanced automatically after just 0.1 second, which is a very small period of time. What does that mean? From slide 14 to 15 will require a manual click, but 15, 16, 17 is automatic. And then of course they will stabilize on 18. So now let's see how nice this looks. Now I have to click and then the rest of it happens automatically. Isn't that brilliant? This would be very difficult to achieve using animation, although it is still possible. Now let's look at the characters. I have just characters from A to Z. And then the second slide, I have morph written. And second slide has morph transition applied. And see how smart this is. It actually picked up the right characters, resized them, positioned them, and job done. Brilliant stuff. Imagine doing this using normal animation. Lot of pain. But now let's see what happens when I have only A to Z, but I have the same character repeating. Now what will it do? There are two H characters, and in my input, so to say, there is only one H character. So observe carefully. When I click, the first H gets animated. The second one doesn't know what to do, so it just appears using a simple fade effect. Okay, now I'm going to cheat the system by putting this another H here. Now see how smart it is. When I run the animation this time, it detects that there are two characters of H and uses both of them intelligently. I'm sure you didn't expect that to happen. So let's go further. Now let's use this knowledge to our advantage. What I've done is that A to Z character string, which was a single text box, I have split into 26 different text boxes. I have not done it manually. In fact, I have a macro called TextSplit, which you can download from my blog, which helps me do such things quickly. So first slide shows all the characters jumbled up. Second slide shows the word thank you with the blue background. And you know how this will work, but look at the visual impact. This would have been extremely difficult to do using simple animation. So now let's apply this to pictures and other objects. What I want to show is a concept where we spend a lot of time on inbox and life is cluttered. So I have a clutter thing shown there. That is a hello font, by the way, and lots of mails lying around. This is the final position I want. So as before, make a copy. And in the copy, I have put these guys outside the boundary of the slide. That's it. Now notice how many shapes there are. I don't even know the actual count. I just created some and copy pasted them randomly. But look at the finesse with which this guy can manage all this very nicely. So now when I click, from nowhere, all these images will come. It'll take a little while because there are too many shapes, but it works seamlessly. So this is how, once you know the concept, you use it to your advantage based on the context. Now let's take something more business-like. And this time, instead of explaining things, I'm going to show you the demo first. So what I really want to explain here is how we struggle to get collaboration done. I have one document, but I need inputs from 4 people. So obviously I have to send CCs to all of them. All of them will type something there and then they will reply back to me. Now I have 5 documents to struggle with, which of course I cannot keep as 5 documents. I'll have to copy paste and make another master document. Hopefully the job is done. No, absolutely not. Because at this point of time, sales doesn't know what the other 3 people have written and vice versa. So I have to send this again repeatedly, not just once, maybe multiple iterations. And that's really painful. And in fact, all this we call teamwork, which is pathetic. So obviously Microsoft has thought about this. You have to remove or discard this bad process and use Office 365. Keep one copy of the document in your OneDrive, share it with people, and then everyone can edit it simultaneously. That is called efficiency. How was this done? Notice there are multiple things happening here. I'm not going to explain all the details. You can download this presentation and figure it out yourself. But just to give you the core concepts, this looks like one, but actually there are 5 copies there. One behind another, superimposed. Second step, show this. Third step, combine. Fourth step, again, back to square one. Every time I'm changing the text as desired. And then to show repetition, like I said before, we did something similar, and these guys have an automatic advance option, and that is what is making it look nicer. So that's how it works. So to summarize, remember that this is not a substitute to animation, it's an adjunct. Both of them have pros and cons. You figure out which one suits you best in a given situation. Now, only duration can be changed in Morph, whereas many other parameters can be changed in case of animation. Effect option in Morph has three things there: object, word, and character. Choose the right one in the right place. Of course, Morph requires you to duplicate slides, which is an overhead, and it may increase the file size also. But if that is a disadvantage, you have to also look at the advantage of the time you save in trying to do it manually using complex animation. Finally, once you understand the core concepts, you can just figure out how to use it in your business situation. The best way to master this is to first learn the core concept, which I'm sure you have already done, and then pick up some presentations you have created recently because that topic is fresh in your mind. Look at each slide and then think where you could have used Morph. That is how you become better in applying the knowledge. So that's it. Thank you. This itself is using Morph. And this one, I'm not going to explain how I did. You download the PPT and figure it out for yourself. Now, I'm aware that many of you don't even have Morph as a feature right now, but it'll come soon. And for a change, even before the feature comes, you have all the knowledge required to utilize it in your day-to-day work. So if you like this video, please subscribe to this YouTube channel and also to my blog, efficiency365.com. Share it with your friends, colleagues, and loved ones. And that's all for now. Thank you.